the news came, I was in Parliament with the Prime Minister. He said, I will go immediately to see the body. So arrangements were made. And after a little wait, Prime Minister drove down. I went in the same vehicle.
A lot of people came to know about his demise and they started pouring in.
I went to Motilal Nehru Marg. And as we entered, Prime Minister walked in. And I was walking behind him when Ahmed Patel pulled me and said, "Bhai, you know, there's a problem. Can you help?" I said, "What is it?" He said, "You know, the cremation has to be done, and party feels the cremation should be done in Hyderabad. You know some of the family members. Why don't you talk to them?" I mean, I looked at Ahmed Patel, and I wanted to first go in and pay my respects. You know, even before I entered the house outside, and I kind of said to myself, "All right." And then I walked in, and I paid my respects to the body, and didn't say a word. I didn't tell anybody anything.
From the family side, we would prefer in Delhi because we always felt that he stayed here for 35 long years, and then it is his karma bhumi. And several times when he was alive, he used to say this. You know, he felt more comfortable in Delhi than in Hyderabad. Mr. Rajshekhar Reddy arrived at turn 5:30, and he started repeating the same thing. Whatever he told me on phone, he said it's better the body is taken to Hyderabad. And he started telling my brothers, my other members of family, and he just said all that, and he left. And it looked as though it was an orchestrated affair.
Both Shivraj Patil, the Home Minister, and Rajshekhar Reddy put pressure on the family, and the family agreed. So I guess if both the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh and the Home Minister of India put pressure on you, anyway, the family agreed.
It was already 10 o'clock in the night, and perhaps the Prime Minister was retiring for the day, but he came out nevertheless in his night dress, and he assured us that a memorial will be made, definitely made in Delhi. The next morning, around 9:30 or so, a gun carriage was brought in, and the body was kept on the gun carriage. The funeral procession started. We were given to understand that the body would be taken to AACC headquarters, where party workers would pay respects, and then of course people who could not visit in the previous day, they would come and pay the last respects. But when we arrived at the headquarters, Congress headquarters, somebody from the crowd said that the gun carriage is too big, it can't enter.
He was wedded to Congressism. I must tell you this. You know, these days, political leaders, people like you, people like me, people like, who are in the corporate world or academic world, or wherever, what do they do in the evenings when they want to socialize? They go to a club, they go to a mall, they go to a coffee place or things. You know where Narasimha Rao used to go? Right? Narasimha Rao used to go to Khadi Bandar in Koti. Narasimha Rao used to go to Khadi Bandar in Koti. He used to sit there. And all those who wanted to meet Narasimha Rao, after 5 o'clock, everybody knew that you go to Koti, Khadi Bandar, you will find Narasimha Rao. So that was his adda. Now, I'm telling you this because, you see, he was attached to Khadi. That was Congressism. He could have gone to exam club. He could have gone to some other place. No, he would go to Khadi Bandar. Khadi Bandar was the place where he used to sit, talk about Hindi literature, talk about state politics, talk about national politics, talk about socialism, talk about something else, talk about international developments. But in Khadi Bandar, amidst the bales of Khadi around him, So that was the quintessential congressman he was, you know, full of congressism. After his death, his body was not allowed to enter the Congress headquarters. That was the humiliation.
The gun carriage was left on the footpath, and a few people, maybe a handful of them, they paid floral tributes, and somebody from the crowd again said, "Okay, let's start. Let's, you know, it's getting late."
Not nice at all. It is not nice. I mean, he was doing opposite her. I mean, his body was not taken into the ICC building. Then, you know, his body was put in a truck, and hardly anybody to see him off at the airport. And while Hyderabad, 6-7 lakh people came for his cremation.
The last rites were performed as per Hindu tradition, and as per the tradition, you know, once the Kapal Moksh is observed, you know, the family is supposed to leave the, you know, cremation ground. At around 11 o'clock, we were about to retire for bed. My sister called up. And she was sounding very upset. I said, "What's the matter? Why are you so upset?" I asked her. He said, "Did you see the TV?" I said, "No, I haven't. What's the matter?" And she said, "No, why don't you put the TV on and see it for yourself?" I said, "Why don't you tell me what's the problem?" He said, "No, they are showing some very disturbing visuals of half-burned body and some stray dogs there, you know, loitering in the burial ground." This is a very traumatic experience for the family, I would say. Good evening, good night, we could sleep. I didn't know what went wrong and who was responsible for this. Whether they could have prevented this,
I honestly do not know. I think it was one of the most tragic things in India's history. And it is one of the most terrible things Congress Party has done.
When he was insulted, when his body was not allowed to enter ICC, or when his body was left half burnt, nobody took care. That's a pity. On his death anniversary, Manmohan Singh would go to the function in the Andhra Pradesh Bhavan, but that was the only gesture he was willing to do.
Post 2004, up to 2014, 10 long years, we tried our best to contact him. We called up several times asking for appointment. And for some reason or the other, none of the family members was given any appointment.
During the 5 years of the 10 years of UPA, The Congress party named a road in Delhi after Rajesh Pilot, after Madhura Sindhya, after Arjun Singh, after so many other Congress leaders, but not one after Narasimha Rao.
Although I had written several letters that one, at least one of the roads should be named after Mr. Narasimha Rao, or a project to be named after Mr. Narasimha Rao. You know, nothing of that sort of has happened even till this day. And why somebody can randomly go and check up in Parliament whether his portrait is there? You'll be surprised to see that there is no portrait of Mr. Narasimha Rao in Parliament till this day.
Actually, for 8 years after his death, there's not a single meeting in Telangana or Andhra Pradesh to commemorate him.
Instead of embracing Narasimha Rao's work as a great prime minister who helped transform India and continuing that work and continuing the unfinished agenda, they disowned his work, they discredited him, they humiliated him during his life, they humiliated after death.
Run, Anandji, run for your life. No one gives a damn for your genius. Escape, dreamer. Save your dreams and your dreaming before they get you condemned, before they destroy the real you and set the hounds of their suborned public opinion against you, so that you may never rise again. Prophetic. I think that's what the Indian political system has done.